Hey, with Jewel tonight, which always makes me happy, makes it a special Tuesday. Hello.
Hi.
Nice to be with you.
Yeah.
You're Texas. Stephenville,
I am.
Texas. Is that close to Tornado Alley? Is that part of it?
You know, it didn't used to be. And then all of a sudden, maybe 7 or 8 years ago, we got tornadoes in Dallas, which was crazy. And then a few weeks ago, not even a few weeks ago already, but it was Granbury, which was hit maybe 20 miles up the road from me. So we did just put in a storm shelter in our house, which is just bizarre. I mean, nobody in our area hardly has them because it's just so unusual. But
What does it look like? I mean, how does it...
Ours is under our garage. We have, like, an open garage, like a carport, sort of.
Okay.
And they came in and only took them one day. They just dug a hole, and then there's a little teeny stairs. It's tiny, but it's a safe...
Is there anything down there? Like,
I just have some water. Yep.
Just water bottles, and other than
and
that...
And some emergency flashlight, and that was it, yeah.
It's just a place to be.
It's just a place to, yeah, be underground.
Amazing the reality of people who live in Tornado Alley in Oklahoma and Moore, Oklahoma, hit the hardest, that this is their reality. There's tornado watches all the time.
Yeah.
And when it turns to tornado warning, that's when everybody takes action. But
I know it's easy for us to sit here and go, why do they live there? You know, if you know you're in a tornado's path, but it's like you mentioned earlier with the earthquakes here, it's just sort of this reality people live with, and you just feel like it's going to happen to somebody else.
Yeah.
Or something, the unreality of it, the odds, and you kind of play the odds. It's where you live. It's where they have their roots. It's where they have their families. It's where they have their ranches, you know.
Do you have friends in Oklahoma?
I do. I have a lot of friends. I'm friends with Blake and Miranda, and, you know, Reba's a dear friend as well. I was just doing a show there 8 or 9 days ago. You know, me and my son were there on my tour bus. I mean, we would have had nowhere to go.
Don't you feel like in life we are dealing with more catastrophes, and maybe I'm just, it's amplified because of social media and cable news, but...
You know, it's funny, I know what you mean, because I think we tend to think everything's worse than it used to be in the good old days, but then you look at, there used to be the Black Plague, and there used to be, you know, all kinds of, you know...
I think that's
awful infirmities and tragedies and, you know, gosh, think of the amazing tragedies throughout history of the inquests and the, I mean, there's just been, people have dealt, you know, we're a species that have dealt with some, you know, not only natural disasters, but some inflicted by our own species. You look at history and it really puts it into context, and you realize, the thing that always strikes me about these times is that we're animals, and it really hits home. I think we're so secure in this little bubble that we live in. We're so modern, and we have great medical attention, and we just feel modern. We feel impervious. And you realize we're animals. We're a little anthill, and the anthill got knocked over, and we're scurrying around trying to help each other.